Question 6 on the 2021 mechanics past paper is a moments question. A uniform rod AB of mass 30 kilograms rests horizontally on two pivots, one at the end A and the other at the point C, as shown in the diagram below. M is the midpoint of the rod. Now, since M is the midpoint of the rod and the mass of the rod is 30 kilograms, well, then the weight acts through the center M. So we have 30G acting at point M and acting downwards. At each of those pivots, A and C, we will have a normal reaction. So we can call them R1 and R2. So there's always a normal reaction whenever you have a pivot. So in all of these questions, all these moments questions, we're going to have downwards and upwards forces. And the downwards and upward forces must be equal, but that's for later on. The distance AC is 1.2 meters. So I've just drawn that in there. The reaction at pivot C is twice the reaction at pivot A. So since I've called this R1 at A and R2 at C, well, since the reaction at pivot C is twice the reaction at pivot A, well, then I can say that R2 is twice R1. So the diagram has to have all the forces for two marks. So our forces are our weight acting downwards, our reactions acting upwards. That's for the two marks. The next question, calculate the reaction at pivot A. Well, since R1 and R2 have to equal 30G, and since R2 is twice of R1, well then that means that three times the reaction at A is equal to 30G. So the reaction at A is 100 newtons. Next question, we have to show that the length of the rod is 1.6 meters. So I've just done a quick sketch here. This 1.2 meters is given in the question from A to C. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to call the distance from A to the midpoint as X. I'll call that X. Now we start to look at moments. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take moments about A. So I'm concentrating here at A. This is where I'm concentrating. And what I'm going to look at is the forces that are acting clockwise around A, and I'm going to equate that to the forces that are acting anti-clockwise around A. And they should be equal. Clockwise equals anti-clockwise, doesn't matter which way around you put them. So my clockwise moments acting around A, I have this 30G, and it is acting at a distance of X meters. So that 30G is acting in a clockwise motion around A at a distance of X meters. The anti-clockwise forces, well, I have 200 newtons acting at a distance of 1.2 meters around A, and that's acting in an anti-clockwise direction. So our clockwise moment of 30G times distance X must be equal to our 200 newtons times distance 1.2. And equating, or solving that little equation, 30G, that's just 300. So we'll do 200 times 1.2 and divide that by 300. That gives us a distance X of 0.8. Now remember that 0.8 is just the midpoint. It's half the length of the rod. We're asked to find the length of the rod, or at least show it's 1.6. So 2 times 0.8 is 1.6. Part 4, a mass of 18 kilograms is now attached to the end. So I've done another sketch, but this time I have an arrow going down the ways with a weight of 18G. Calculate the new reactions at the pivots A and C, given that the rod remains horizontal and in equilibrium. So I've chosen again to take moments about A. So I'm going to look at my clockwise moments. My clockwise forces are here and here, and they act at two different distances. So our 30G acts at a distance of 0.8, so that's 30G times 0.8. Our 18G acts at a distance of 1.6, the full length of the rod. So those are our clockwise moments. Our anti-clockwise moment, there only is one, is our R2, and it's acting at a distance of 1.2. So R2 is what we're looking to find out. So multiplying everything out here gives us 1.2 times the reaction at R2. So R2 is therefore 440. Now we're asked to find both R2 and R1, but remember from before that the upwards forces must equal the downwards. So the reactions must equal the weights. So our two reactions must be equal to 30g plus 18g. We've just worked out one of the reactions, so the second reaction therefore is 40 newtons.